I didn't do these labs because virtual reality was fancy. I have been doing lab videos for many years, and I knew that lab videos are a good way to explain small parts of the lab to a student. And we have validated that, and we knew you can use that to teach how to use instrumentation, you can teach people how to make calculations. So I knew the medium worked. It's just that watching a flat video about your lab is not the most exciting thing. And so when I started to see things done in virtual reality, I thought, you know, this is just so real and immediate and exciting. And if we could create a lab that happens this way, then that would make people feel exactly like they're in the lab. So virtual reality is super cool, but it's also the perfect tool to deliver that immersive experience. And then I wanted to make virtual reality labs for the students that couldn't come to lab. So pregnant students, students that had any kind of disability, and it doesn't have to be a permanent disability. If you break your leg, you can't come to the lab, right? Because you can't stand that long. If you get deployed as military personnel, you're gone. And I felt like we should have a way to reach out to those people who can't physically be present in the lab. So I was super fortunate that Delta got on board with that. I mean, Delta's like the best. They got on board with that idea. They gave us the space and the money to explore that idea. And then we ended up putting the whole first semester of organic chemistry online and offer it as a distance education course. And that was exciting up until that point. And at that point, we had a cap of 10 students per semester taking the lab in that mode, because the department thought that's more than enough for these students who can't be in lab. And then when the COVID-19 hit, it was like, wow, all of a sudden, nobody can come to the lab. So everybody became a candidate to use the virtual reality labs. And we knew that they work, which was super exciting to us. I mean, we knew that we weren't putting a product out there that wasn't tested and that we weren't sure if it was gonna work. We knew it was gonna work because we had tried it, we had validated it, we had published it. And so we felt very comfortable, you know, putting the videos out there, and we shared them with everybody. And a lot of other universities adopted the videos right away because they were that good, and they were the only ones available anywhere. So that was super exciting. I mean, I know that the rest of the team feels the same way. You know, we did something that took so long and it was so hard because there was no precedence. You know, we didn't copy anybody. This is something that is 100% an NC State product. We made it from scratch. We created all the stuff that you see in the video was made specifically for that product. And then all of a sudden, everybody's using it. So that's really very exciting.